Hi, welcome to another video from Project Playthroughs. We are still playing Dark Souls, as you can imagine. We are going through at an incredibly slow pace, and I just hate it. So, to speed things up, I have taken the liberty of deciding that I will cut the unnecessary crap out, like grinding and all of the other things like that. So we're just gonna kind of get started here. If you haven't seen the other videos, I'm doing a playthrough, project playthroughs. Gosh, don't you just hate when you forget how to speak and everything goes to shambles? It's okay. Alright, game will start in offline mode. Right, let me take a drink, and then we'll try again. So, we have just defeated the gargoyles, and are about to head down to the infamous Blight Town. This is notoriously the toughest part of the game. Okay, not toughest, most frustrating. It sucks. You'll see why, but basically the developers, when they designed it, caused everything to glitch out and the frame rate just drops. So we're going to rest at the bonfire and go from there. You might have noticed that I am the only member of this channel so far who is including their face in these game recordings. Others have decided not to do it for various reasons, but I'm still actually debating the effectiveness of including my face in these videos. I'm not really sure to what advantage one including his or her face would have. Goodbye. I actually been thinking a lot about internet privacy and all of that crap, and just that these videos will be on here for the rest of eternity, or as long as the internet exists. So I simultaneously hope that this can propel, if I do this well, this will, I guess, help me along. Although I'm not including my name in the videos, my real name, not the fictitious name, unless you actually thought my name was Project, and which, I'm gonna break on my tangent to talk to this guy, and so he's kind of a jerk. Not enough for you, well, let's not agree now, kihi. Yeah, okay, so basically, he kills the firekeeper. That may be a bad idea. Okay, so now I actually have to kill him. Or he'll kill me. Right, so that wasn't supposed to happen. Awkward. Alright, so what I was talking about, privacy. If I do this well, I assume, well, I hope I'm doing it well. Feedback is always appreciated. I think that this could actually be very beneficial, or it could come and bite me in the butt. We'll see. For now, I think I've decided to include all of the things, and by all of the things I mean my face, in this video. Okay, let's see if this guy will actually come kill us now. Oh yeah, he's right. Yeah, okay, that was a bad idea. So the idea is that we were supposed to, like, we're gonna try and get him to do that, cause he's dumb. He's so dumb. And we'll get our souls. Okay. So Now, what will happen is we're going to go back up to the bonfire. Sit at the bonfire. And we're going to try and see if the item was left. I might have to hit the loading screen. Yep, okay. So, yeah, I'll just run and jump off the edge. Because there's that item there. You can kind of see it. Well, I pointed at it on the screen and you can't see where I'm pointing. But you saw that little yellow dot. And that little yellow dot is awesome. I like it. It's good. So, very tough to actually kill. It's a lot easier if you just kick them off to begin with. Right, so, this is probably, like, the easiest way to get to Blighttown. There is another way. You can go kind of the back way. And, yeah, I don't know, it's... The back way is just, like, long and tiresome. And just, all in all... Yes, offer Firekeeper Soul. Can I do it again? Oh, no, I only have one Firekeeper Soul. Okay, so that basically makes your Estus Plus stronger. yep. So, we're gonna go all the way down. Now, I was talking about internet privacy and all sorts of stuff. So it's actually quite interesting what the internet knows and doesn't know about you, and so part of the reason why I am fairly okay with producing these videos and having my face included in them is that regardless if my face is included in this or not, if you wanted to find out, say, my actual name, it's not that hard to do. Now it's really about, like, what's... Oh. Okay, you just saw that master key thing, that's why you want to have the master key. Because it opens up that door. If you don't have the master key, it kind of sucks. So, sorry about that. Right, so yeah, if you actually wanted to find out any information about me, it's quite possible. That goes for any of you who are watching this video. Google knows that you've watched this video. And they are quite happy to recommend, or... tell Amazon that you've watched this video, and so if you watch a bunch of videos about gaming, you will likely see advertisements regarding gaming. I know, crazy, but... Blighttown. As you can see, it's Blighttown. Frame rate drops like entirely. Oh, and that's poison. Ouch. Okay. So. I don't know why I came down to this area. This is not the right area for me to be in. This is just going to be... So yeah, the ground poisons you. Everything kills you. Oh, yeah, this is a bad idea. So, I did just try to go into dark. No, oh my gosh. Wow, you cannot speak. Okay. So, that was me trying to do Blighttown and chickening out and being like, no, I don't feel ready for this. And that's okay. I don't have to feel ready for it. What I do need to do is go to a certain area, and I gotta remember how to get there. So, I want to go to kill not the chupacabra, but Carastino. Oh, what are they called? I do not remember. This is not the right way to go. You can fast travel in Dark Souls, but not till later in the game, when you get the item called basically it's a bowl that lets you fast travel. It's a bowl. You get a bowl and somehow that lets you fast travel. I totally walked past. Yeah, it's a good thing I didn't die. That would have not been good, because then I would have started all the way back at Blighttown and then had to come all the way back here, and that just chews up a lot of time. Rest at bonfire. Okay, level up. No, I can't level up. I've got nothing. Let's go down here and to the blacksmith. Hooray, blacksmith. One of the few people that you run into that doesn't want to kill you. Reinforced weapon. There we go. Now it does a bit more damage. Don't get yourself killed. I don't know if I have a long range weapon. Let's see. Change equipment. I have a light crossbow. Talk. Well, hello again. Let's we're not doing that. We're gonna do one of these. Ooh. Maybe I wanna go level up with that. No, I won't be able to. I won't be able to level up. Enforged. I need purchase item. Oh, by the way, you wanna get, as soon as you're able to, although don't, you wanna get a repair box, armor smith box, and weapon smith box as soon as you can. I know I can right now, so don't do as I say, not as I do. And I need to buy lots of these. Wood bolt. Okay, what's the 10 damage, but they're a third of the cost. But I can get like 107 of these. Yes. Yes, let's get 107 of them. You'll see why in a second. So, don't get yourself killed, I know, thank you very much. Okay. We're gonna go over here and apply. He's 123. Take this out. And oh do to do. Oh my gosh, what is that? Why is it shooting lightning at me? Kaboom. And now begins the incredibly long process of shooting stuff. And there you have it. That is how you kill that thing when you are such a low level. Now you're probably thinking, wow, Project, that was really, really cheap of you. Well, guess what? That's pretty much the majority of Dark Souls playing, is just finding little loopholes and exploiting them. That is pretty much how you do it. You exploit until you are actually strong enough. Which is actually a very good representation of North American business. Let's see. What do I want to do? Require that. It's always a good idea to repair. I don't know why I repaired that, but I did. Keeps your equipment in tip-top shape. And do I have any more of these? No, I don't. Dang. Because I don't think that'll be enough. Okay, well, for now, we will do this. Jump. Oh, I know what I'm doing. Go back, go back. Project, let's go back. Level up our halberd. It's not halberd. I realized in the last video I kept saying halberd. And then was... Oh, I can only buy one. Oh, I bought two. Didn't mean to do that. Oh, but guess what I have? I've got one of these. So let me level up at least once. I want that. Okay. Let's see. What are we going to do here? We are going to reinforce our weapon. Ha 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 ha.
How about you just the halberd, not halbred, you dummy? You dummy? Don't be dumb. Alright, let's go. But Project, I don't want to hear any of your silly voices.
Well, guess what, Public? Oh, that's a great... Yes, I like that. I will call you Public. I am Project. Okay.
What was I saying? Oh, what I was saying. Project, we don't like to hear any of your silly voices.
Well, Public, if I can help it, I'll try not to do all my silly voices, but the problem is I get rather bored talking in my normal monotone voice, so, yeah, it's gonna have to just happen. And then you'll also have to deal with all the inconsistencies in my voice. So, instead of Bladetown, I recommend going to the Darkroot Gardens, where you will find lots of really friendly plants, like this one, that are hidden. Uh-oh. And that one. Death. And death to you. Death to you again. Alright. Because you get Purple Musk Lump, and they are very good at... They get rid of all the poison and the toxin. Well, Blooming Purple Moss Clump gets rid of toxic and poison, and Purple Moss Clump just gets rid of poison. Red Moss Clump gets rid of bleeding, all that sort of thing. So to get in there, you have to have the Crest of Adorus, or basically that really expensive item that I couldn't buy. Oh, and I wish there was a bonfire here. Well, guess what? Secret walls! Yeah, the base of this game has lots of secret walls, if you did not know. And yeah. So, we're going to kill the most gracious Moonlight Butterfly. And you're probably wondering, is it through that fog door? Well, yes, but not directly after. Okay, so there's a bit of an ambush, and you have to deal with this ambush. The ambush doesn't actually have that item that's in the middle, so now you can pick that up and not have to worry about these guys coming to life and killing you. Just a tip from one player to another.
Okay, so we are going to go all the way through here. As you can see, there is no boss because the fog door has disappeared. And we will go. Yeah. Before I get over here, I will show you this. Why is a tree moving? Well, guess what? You can stab it and hurt it. And hurt it some more. Oh. You can't lock on that, but you're just gonna keep cutting it down. And then it goes away. And you're like, what? And there's a chasm. So, we can go down there. But first, we're going to try and hurt these guys. This guy right here. We're gonna stab him. No, we can't stab him. Okay, so he's doing that thing, which makes us super slow. And unable to roll. Oh. Because he's a jerk. But thankfully, he is very big and very fat. But he does a tremendous amount of damage. They are manageable, one at a time. But handled in groups, I don't think you can kill them at this level. We are too poor. Yeah. So, if we walk around here, what do we find? It's very interesting. Oh, this is a. Here's the guy. I found him. So, we're gonna try and kill this guy. If I can hit him. Very hard. Alright, yeah, we got you. You suck, you're the worst. Uh-oh. Okay. I am tired. Is my sleepiness making you tired? Okay, now here's also a weird thing. See that? It's a tree snake. Tree lizard? Snake lizard? I don't know. Partisan. Cool. Fun stuff. Okay, and then that's where that guy would pop up and then try and kill us. So, we will continue our stretch along here. We don't go in the middle because there's a bunch of scary stuff in the middle. Really, the question begs, am I ready to kill the Moonlight Butterfly? And I can't answer that question, honestly. But, okay, we're just gonna try this. Bad idea, this is a bad idea. Oh, frig. Let's go. Evasive maneuvers, let's go. And we're gonna run as close to the thingamabobber as we can. To the bonfire. Maybe we can bottleneck them. We'll see. Okay. Let's make the stand. Okay. One down. There's like a lot to go. Uh-oh. The vegetation does not help with fighting. Alright, so we got these guys. Where are the stone giants? This is my real question. Okay. Oh, they're tired of me. They're like, nah, we don't want to deal with this. I don't know where they're going. Okay. So, next on our list of to-dos is to try and kill these guys. So this will be fun. Alright, let's go.
I do not feel prepared to take on both of these guys. Oh, there's three of them. That's nice. Back up, back up, back up, back up, back up. Oh no, you're kidding me. Oh, I'm so dead. Yeah. Are you stuck there? Please be stuck there. Please don't be able to get through. Because, like, that would be super nice. Super convenient for me. Uh oh. Ouch! Okay, that was a little too aggressive. Are you getting through? That's a better question. Are you too fat? Oh, good, you're too fat.
Oh!
Woo! Ha! Alright. Oh. That was too aggressive. Too aggressive. Come on, Project. Oh. Okay. Easy peasy. Pumpkin squeezy. Let's see. Oh, no, that wasn't easy peasy. Not easy peasy. Okay. Let's go, let's go. Oh, no, screw you, screw you. Okay, yeah, you suck, you're the worst. Haha. I win, you lose. And still hasn't dropped anything. Huh. Interesting. Okay, so there's one more. I think I'll be able to kill him. I'm not sure. Ugh, I'm scared. I'm so scared. Am I really, though? Am I really scared, or is it just, like, getting into the game? Ugh. Okay. I think I'll be able to take on this guy if it's just him. Fun. Oh no. Oh gosh. Darn. Oh, boy. We're gonna bring him back up here. Nope. No, come back. Where are you going? Nope. Haha. Not gonna kick his shield down. That's just not happening. But, there we have it. Somehow, I've killed all of them. That just, yeah, that happened. Okay. Or, okay, 20 minutes is the goal. It will probably be closer to 30 minutes. So, you run around this guy, and you run up these stairs before you can get up and chase after you. Now, a good thing to have with the Moonlight Butterfly is that she, why do I assume she, it could be a he. It, I guess I can call it a nit because it's not a person, just a butterfly, is all its attacks are magic, so if you have good magic defense, it's actually a lot easier. Oh, yeah. So, oh boy. A lot of dodging. A lot of just running back and forth. When you get hit with that one, it really sucks. Okay, I think I remember the pattern for that one. Oh, yeah. That one really, really sucks. Now it switches sides again. What are you doing? Land. When it lands, that's when you really go for it. Oh my gosh. Ugh. Will you just stop? Just land already, please. Oh, thank you. Okay, come here. Boom. 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 Uh-oh. Run. Back up. Because that one sucks. That attack really hurts you. And rinse and repeat. But just try not to get hit as much as I do. I didn't need to assist there, but I did anyways. Ugh, okay. So much waiting. I think the secret to success in this game is patience. Oh my gosh. He's really... It is... Yeah, I can call him he. I can call whatever I want. He's really taking a toll on me. I just want him to land. I should probably roll out of the way. Okay, this is a good time to ask this. Alright. Yes, perfect. So. Oh, bad idea. Oh, that was risque. Very risque. Risky? Very risky. I don't know if risque and risky are two different things. But. I think they are. I don't know. And you're like, wow, you're so bad at English. I know. Oh my gosh. I forgot about that one. Drink. Double S this. Oh my gosh. So annoying. So annoying, oh my gosh. Like, ugh. Drink up. Just land already. And you are dead. Oh, thank goodness. That was quite the excursion. And 10,000 souls. So that is 100% an optional boss. You don't actually have to do this fight. But, on the other hand, there are some pretty sweet rewards for going out of your way to do stuff you don't necessarily want to do. And if you go up here, you're like, wow, that looks a lot like the other blacksmith. And continue. Pillage. And then we're good. So, yeah, there's nothing else here. Don't spend that much time. You want to get the divine ember so you can create divine weapons. But that's really, like, your style of play and all of that. Thank you for watching Raven's Congress. This has been Project Playthroughs. We just killed the Moonlight Butterfly. Please like and subscribe. And if this wasn't your cup of tea, please check out our other amazing channels. See you next time.